20th birthday. But before we get into it, because it's a very, very special story, and I hold it very close to my heart because it's an experience that I'll never forget. But before we get into it, let's do my intro.
My freaking 20s crying. Oh my god, I was so looking forward to sleeping live, watching the sunset with everyone. Oh, but Optus doesn't work on this freaking island. And I was told yesterday to go get a SIM card with Telstra. And what did I do? Oh, it'll be fine. I'm sure Optus works on this island. No. Optus does not work, and I can't sleep. Why? I don't want to even be here anymore.
Yeah, I was full of emotion. I was so upset. I was also drinking as well, so I was a little tipsy. As you can tell, I'm a little. But yeah, that was 2 years ago. And I just remember. Just like God, like I was just so upset. So here's the story. I wrote it down because when it happened, I was like, I want to remember this forever and all the little details. So let's get into it. I hope that maybe this video will inspire you. Maybe it'll touch you. I really hope it does. I might cry. I don't know, because I get really emotional. But yeah, I just really hope that God may even touch you when I read this story to you. So, I hope you enjoy it. Okay. was turning 20 years old, so it was a very big number for me. It was a very big deal. I felt very alone and really upset. And I was just talking to God, and I said to God, I just really need a hug. I'm so alone and so upset right now. So I got up after I cried in that video. I got up and I opened the door to the balcony and I looked out over the ocean because I was on an island. I looked out over the ocean into the distance, crying out to God. Not in real life form, but in the spirit. I just saw an angel come down right onto my balcony and wrapped its arms around me. I saw an angel come down right onto my balcony. It was like flew in onto my balcony and wrapped its arms around me. It didn't feel like a normal hug. It felt like a blanket wrapping around me that just filled me with so much joy, love, and peace. And I remember having the biggest smile on my face. I was so happy. It was truly quite an experience that God met me right then and there. He met me right then and there and showed me that He was with me, even in this scary and lonely moment. Especially on a day that is so important to me, which is my birthday. Right after this happened, I went downstairs to the bar. And after I ordered my margarita, this lady tapped me on the shoulder. So I turned around and she asked me, "Are you alone?" And I said, "Yes," trying not to cry. She then asked me, "You look like you need a hug." And I just broke down in tears in her arms because back up in my room, I asked God for a friend. So I wasn't alone, and that I needed a hug. It just shows that God can use anyone, Christian or not Christian, and used this lovely lady who I've never met before, who gave me a hug. Her and her boyfriend, they came back to my room and talked to me and comforted me all night, not all night, but like till like 9 o'clock, and we were just having a chat, and I'm just sitting there and I'm like, wow. I'm talking to these two complete strangers that were with me, and they're like, "We're gonna make you feel so special, it's your birthday." And so the next day I woke up and I met with them in the lobby, and they spent like literally the whole day with me. They went swimming with me, they took me out snorkeling because it's on the Great Barrier Reef in Australia. And then on the last day they invited me on their helicopter flight. I think I paid like the extra like $300, which is so cheap. They took me on their helicopter to the reef. I went snorkeling. they looked after me, they spent time with me, made sure that I wasn't alone, and then for them to invite me on the helicopter flight, which is like thousands of dollars, I'm just like, wow, God pulled through and he gave me the best birthday. It was truly like just being in that room and like that angel coming down and like giving me that hug that I really needed, and then going down to the bar. There wasn't many people on the island and she gave me a hug. I'm just like, and I'm a very like antisocial person. I'm very like quiet. I don't like talking to people. It was just such an eye-opening experience. So I wrote that story down. I came home and I told my family and my parents, and they were just like, wow, like that's amazing, Tom. And I'm like, it is, it's so cool. I have like a few other times when God met me and touched me, but I will do that in more other videos. But I guess I just want to say, if you are feeling alone, that God is there. And maybe you haven't reached out. I could have stayed there in my room, crying, being upset, but I reached out to God. Touched me. you know, hang out with you and spend that time with you. But I know there can be so much distractions. Our phones, social media, we are literally bombarded. We are literally bombarded every single day. See, I was literally just bombarded with a message. There's always things going on, notifications. You need to find a time just to silence them out. Spend that time with God. And yeah, I'm just really thankful that you've given me the time to share this with you and talk about God. Because I know sometimes I get scared or a little bit nervous, or I start shaking because I'm just like, oh, I don't know how people are gonna take it, but I just really hope that this message touched you. I've got a few more stories, but I'll save them for next time, of when I had a dream. Pray and Abby. this video, because it happened for a reason. Nothing happens for no reason, and I just thank you, Lord, for allowing me to share this message with them. In your name, I pray. Amen. Well, thank you for watching. Thank you for this video. I hope the message touched you. And maybe you got something out of it, because it's my birthday next week. It's actually today, next week, on Tuesday. So, I'm excited. I wanted to get this video done before then, as like a little 2-year anniversary. I asked God and I prayed that no one would interrupt me in this video. No one's home. The postman hasn't come yet. And I'm just really grateful that I was able to get this video done. So yeah, I love you all so much. This is just a start. This is the start of something new. Well, I've done these videos before, but I'm gonna start doing them again. Thank you for watching. I love you all so much. I hope you have an incredible day.